The good news of this week is that planning is now taking place to safely reopen our lives. Mayor Fadness introduced a recovery plan today to the City Council. And we too are planning for the reopening of schools after summer break. We're reviewing how the city recovery plan supports our need for a safe and healthy environment for all. Our planning team will be reviewing a number of scenarios for next school year, ranging from a routine face-to-face reopening to a model in which school starts later in the year and perhaps even under the current e-learning format. Safe and healthy conditions for all is the number one priority in any plan. Provisions for health-impaired students and staff, testing for all, appropriate personal protective equipment, and the enforcement of healthy procedures throughout the organization are common strands of any scenario we consider. Our planning, however, is not the only news of the week. HSC will not be providing or sponsoring any camps, classes, or extracurricular activities in the month of June. We remain optimistic that activities can resume after the week of July 4th, but that too will be determined after questions of personal health and safety are addressed. Students registered for high school summer PE are advised to be attentive to news for online options. Toward the end of last school year, we administered a survey to our students, staff, and family, referred to it as the Panorama Survey because it's a survey created by Panorama Education of Boston. This year, we will administer a different version of this survey, one that focuses on student, family, and teacher experience in the COVID-19 crisis. It will ask for feedback on e-learning, on school district support for learning, on how you are dealing with quarantining, etc. Be looking for that survey on or soon after May 4th, and more to come on that. Our next school board meeting is scheduled for 5 o'clock next Wednesday afternoon, April 29th. Again, it will be online, and comments about items on the agenda may be submitted to President Michelle Fulhart or myself by sending an email message. I encourage you, again, to continue to monitor our frequently asked questions on our COVID-19 website. Details on e-learning, food services, grading, and many other issues are frequently updated, and we want you to be informed. I began with good news, and I'll end with it. Our Fishers Junior High Principal, Dr. Crystal Thorpe, was selected by her peers as a District Principal of the Year. We congratulate her as she moves forward in the process for selection as Indiana Principal of the Year. And HSC is proud to announce that the U.S. Department of Education has awarded us the Green Ribbon Schools Award for our work in environmental education and sustainability. Finally, thank you for all you are doing to promote learning. Take care of yourselves, stay healthy, and remember, we're in this together.